Show 'em how it's done. Terrify the members of the love boat. Show 'em how it's done. We'll be right back.
outside, but it was still in the zone. It was still hittable.
It was my Quisenberry. It's
a tick outside, but it's yeah, you can launch it. It's good. From Ponca City, Oklahoma, Mr. Scott Denver.
See you every day.
thank you to our new friend Daniel Markham for playing. My goodness. What a gift. It's incredible to get to share the stage with him. And thank you to our old dear friend and family member, Patterson Hood, from the Yeah! mid-September of 2001, our band, we were traveling out on the East Coast right during the events of September 11th, and there was a period of days where there were numerous show cancellations for obvious reasons up in the Northeast, and we kind of were in a very uncertain situation as to whether we should just go home or we should keep touring. And so we took a few days and laid low at our dear friend Jeff Macklin's house and figured out the rest of the tour. But we got down to Athens right around September 15th or 16th. And we played to about 20 people at a venue called Tasty World. And one of those 20 people standing in the very front row was Patterson. With a tray full of drinks and a leather jacket on, with a big smile on his face, just jumping around, and it was wonderful. So we wound up hanging out a little bit later that night, and I think we wound up staying at his house, and the friendship was forever formed at that point. And fast forward just a couple of weeks later, and the Drive-By Truckers are out on the first round of Southern Rock Opera touring, self-booked. And they're playing all kinds of places. I mean, to look at that tour schedule, it made me tired just looking at the string of dates that they were playing. And one of those dates happened to be the University of North Texas homecoming festival that they were having just outside of the stadium. And so
you guys did it. You guys played that, right? That's awesome. You guys did it. You made it. What was it?
We got homecoming.
What are you fucking doing after?
They were the unofficial homecoming kings that day. It was really beautiful. But anyway, Scotty and I and a couple of our friends, we sort of crest this hill, and outside of this tent, there's bounce castles and snow cones, and it's all family style. There's kids just running around, and it's pure unbridled joy on a sunny day. And inside this tent, there's about 35 or 40 of us, maybe. I poke my head inside the tent, and there's just nothing but draft beer and cigarettes, and the Truckers taking the stage, and I believe they opened with Buttholeville that day. And that's when I knew the friendship
was on. Stay classy.
Family style is a different kind of family. So anyway, we very much enjoyed the whole set. We wound up hanging with them all day, and they came over to my house. We went out for Steve's barbecue, and they were playing at the old Dan's bar that night. And they were like, "Hey man, we don't have an opener. You want to come sit in a chair and play your songs and open?" And so I did, and it turned out to be, I believe, the last show at the old space in September of 01. But anyway, long story, far too long. Thank you, Patterson Hood, for being such a part of our family. For these years of friendship and love. I think the four of us have fought for our band, Centromatic, really hard over these almost 18 years. But I would say that Patterson has fought for us just as hard, if not harder. So thank you so much. Here's a Christmas song about prostitution.
until the day when it knew that it might not be quite so magic. It was a day when she knew that she might not be quite so attractive. Yeah, it's coming down. tapestries arranged for the day. Seems dangerous to me. Tinsel and stunted.
snow. Looking back and our sky had turned too cold.
In the fall of 2001, I got to live right next door to Dan Mojica. I went knowing by way of Dan's silver leaf. But we spent many nights just listening to playoff baseball on the radio and sitting on the front porch drinking beers and creating a really solid friendship. It's been a joy to get to play over at the old Dan's Bar and here at Dan's Silverleaf and to get to call each of them home base for years. And this song's dedicated to him. It's the Mighty Midshipman.
a rearranged shows on my sympathy. And I had the new masters that stood in the way. All held on tape loose. It's just like you do. It's just like you do. It's just like you do. And the future is brimming. A buzz with excitement. A crimson cushion. A squirm away. Just sleeping in the trailer. It's just like you do.
Texas. We are very grateful. Very, very grateful. Thank you.
Break it. Fuck it.
What are you going to do? Fire us now? Fuck it. Let's just break some shit.
It was like a ridiculously stupid thing. How are you doing this?
Don't second guess yourself.
What did you put in that singer's throat spray?
You like that?
It's exciting.
Yeah. Going on a different planet, are you?
I think I might have a new.
It's
really nice. It's sort of a couple skate jam. We don't have a lot of super sexy jams, but this might be one of the sexier jams.
Bullshit.
So you go. So you stay. Your life saves. Come on.
stuff again?
Yeah.
It's like the first time I smoked clothes in 1984 and heard the Replacements' Let It Be. I couldn't fucking believe it.
I love clothes.
Those clothes.
Sucks that smoking's bad for you. Sucks.
Them clothes though.
Loved smoking. I did. I loved it. It was weird. I wasn't even like a coffee smoker or whatever. It was fun smoking. Don't do it ever. Don't fucking smoke. It sucks.
I think
it's so weird. It's like this weird stuff. I mean, you know, it's not good for you. But what is it? Am I going on a weird place right now?
Yeah, it's good. It's good. It's good. I'm addicted to Lunchables. That shit is fucking thick right now, man. I gotta get off tour. Let's take a break. Cause soon there's gonna be a lot of family in my face.
I'll help you, man. I'll help you. I'll help you through this. Help you through this. Oh,
alright, here we go. We're gonna try this one.
Lunchables are awesome.
Single.
coming to terms with the Lunchables addiction just before the holidays. Pretty much the first step.
Yeah. Our gear saved all the shit for the last show, man. Just saved all the
gear.
Was
like,
the
okay, demons. I get it. It's over.
Yeah.
Missouri, Mr. Matthew Lewis Pence, right there.
About 18 years ago this week, Matt and I sat in this house over on Bernard Street working on a record called We Do the Steps. I get questions, man, they're asking me. At any rate. Gas blowing out the right, just to make the matters worse for the night. So we destroyed everything in our sight. We did fine. We did fine. We did fine. We'll visit family and friends in our sleep. The underbelly of the nation starts to weep. We're kicked around and tossed about in our 2D. We did our time, we did our time, we did our time. And desperation sweeps the countryside. It contradicting the standards we had a body. We shit our mouths and think our thoughts, just keeping in stride. And it's hard to hide, and it's hard to hide. As the cancer dropped upon the camp early this morning, and the blisters were free and the bandages were torn in. It was 61 and 62, we're laid to rest. We did our best. We did our best. We did our best. We kept making Read of the Stacks, and just a few weeks later, we figured out I had a benefit show booked over at the Argo for the Good Bad Art Club in February of 97. And Chris Weber confirmed that when he said, yeah, come on over and play, do your normal Centromatic electrified solo sort of thing. I said, okay, cool, see you there. But then I got this wild, wild thought. Maybe Matt and Mark and I should just go over the songs acoustic and take a bunch of electric gear down there and just turn it all up as high as we can and play them super loud. And Chris Weber and the Good Bad folks were a little surprised when we started loading a bunch of gear through the doors. And so we had our first show without a true rehearsal. And then we went on and had our second show without a true rehearsal.
Good idea.
Yeah, don't rehearse. As Mike Cooley said, it's the one thing, it's the fastest thing that breaks a band up is rehearsing, so there's no need for that. Just a few weeks later, Scott Dambaum joined the fold. And that was it. This is our band. We've been together since March 97, and we're so elated. to call Baby Texas home. There's no way that this would have happened without the energy and the spirit and the community and the creativity of what was going on here in Denton, musically and artistically at that time. There's no way our band would have come to be. But given the love and the support and the trust that we found in each other and also in all our fans that we started to develop, we found our band. And so I know many of you have been with us since that time. So thank you guys so much. Yeah.
I'm just saying.
Thank you.
So I'm gonna play a little tune. It's called jazz music.
We were heathens indeed. Look at us. Look at us all. Damn, it's a thing of beauty. I love it so much.
Yeah! Yeah.
Thank you for being here with us tonight. We are symptomatic. And in so many ways, I think we're all just symptomatic. It feels so good to be here. In Denton, Texas. It's been a wild, crazy 3 weeks of a lot of Lunchables. And stored Zimas, a lot of Zima from 1996.
Expert. Deep glass.
through the urine. Two out of the three best sweater nights of my whole life this weekend.
Sweater nights.
It smells so good too. It's Downy Fresh. We'll be right back.
do a shot.
Get about 75 beers to the stage real quick.
On my sweaters, 'cause you came to show me the light. My heart is thumping, yeah, it's out of sight. 'Cause you change your glass of the sun, yeah, it's easy to tell you're the one. It seems that love that I found me somehow is changing the fur on my squirrels.
okay. It's okay to get mad. I get mad sometimes. I get mad, I get sad, I get happy, I get sappy, I get gay, I get straight, I get beer, I get water.
Without you.